Let me get that.
I can manage.
Is your hip giving you grief today?
Always gives me grief. And I managed for the last 10 years, so you're a little late for the knight in shining armor routine.
Suit yourself, I'm only trying to help.
God damn it, Stephen. I'm not some useless, sappy girl that you can just string along forever. Look around you. I made all of this. I built it on my own when everyone else had written me off as some poor little cripple.
You know that's not how I see you.
Well, you weren't there, were you? No. You'd given up on me long before the accident.
What do you want from me, Lizzie? I love you. I'll do anything.
Anything except okay? I thought not. I love you too, but sometimes I think you just say what you think everyone else wants to hear.
Touch it. It's fine.
It's like a sunburn, but it's a funny shape. Is it sore?
I can't feel it at all. Don't fuss over it.
I can't believe that you left Kate there. Why won't you tell me what happened?
She's probably not even noticed I've gone. It's really nothing.
You're lying. Don't lie to me.
Fine. We had a row.
all their stuff still yet?
Screw this, Di. There's 15 people up there left in 2 days. I don't like it. Where's the baby?
Asleep in the caravan. Sean, I don't want to sit around you waiting for it to get worse. I reckon if we leave now, we can get out of the valley before they get their acts together and close the roads.
You think so?
Yeah, we can go the back roads, through the woods. I'll leave some money on the side for Mrs. Graves. You know her husband isn't back yet either.
He's a boozer, right? That's what I've heard. That's her problem anyway.
Don't be unkind, Sean.
Come on, let's go and get Dylan.
I think it was instant. I know that's no help.
Can you leave me alone?
There was nothing we could do. I'm sorry. I'm really sorry, Pet.
You've woken the baby. Just leave me alone.
Rachel, I'm sorry. Sorry.
This is Kate Collins and Stephen Appleton. Leave a message.
Stephen, it's me. I'm leaving. I've waited as long as I can. If you are there to meet me, I'm leaving for the station now, but I am going anyway, whether you're there or not. But I love you. Please be there. I love you.
Rachel?
Hey, what on earth's going on?
It's been awful. The thunder and the lightning and all the power went out. And everyone was in the hall, so I told them all to stay put. But then Sean Davis said he wasn't going to be told what to do by a stupid bloody girl and went out for a cigarette. And then didn't come back. And then Di, she went out after him and she didn't come back either.
Where is Dylan? Was he with Sean and Di?
No, I'd be looking after him. Do you think they'll come back?
I
don't know, Rachel.
I don't care what anyone thinks. I just know if he was my baby, I could never leave him. Even if the whole war was coming to an end, I'd make sure he came first.
You'd be a good mum, Rachel. Oh, don't worry. It's fine. Go back inside and tell everyone that they're doing a great job. A really wonderful job. I just got a few things to finish up here, and then I'll come in and join you.
Right.
Go on.
It's too dangerous. You don't understand what's happening.
No, you don't understand. We can solve this. We can find a way. I just need more power. I need to amplify the signal, and I can't do it on my own. You saw the opportunity. You ran the numbers, remember?
We're responsible for all this. You and me.
It's not just you and me anymore, though, is it?
Jesus, Kate, you're trying to talk to her, aren't you? Kate, you can't.
Steven, I have to.
It's completely dead. It won't start.
It's only a short walk to the camp. I think we should split up. You go and fetch Rachel. I'll go back to the village and find Evie.
I don't think we should split up.
I don't want to either, Charlie, but we've got to. I'll meet you back at my house later on, okay? We can talk properly then.
Why won't you tell me what happened?
No, actually, you should stay at the camp tonight. Come and find me in the morning. Bring Rachel back. She's going to need her mother.
Meg.
Just take care of her.
Meg!
What is it, Charlie?
Nothing. Just be careful.
I will, I promise. You as well. I'll see you later on.
Why on earth are you there? Why aren't you calling from home?
It's hard to explain. I'm having to move around to follow it. When it finds a suitable host, it begins to amplify. Sorry, I'm not making much sense.
They're talking about flu and a quarantine on the radio, but this... I know you're not that kind of doctor, but it all just sounds really weird.
We don't know exactly what it is yet, but it's got something to do with the other night.
Stephen, your face, the mark, do you think you're infected?
It's not a disease, Lizzie. It's something else. There's something Kate said about patterns. I can't grasp it clearly yet.
Okay, come over. Have some lunch. We can talk properly. Have you spoken with Kate?
Well, she's locked herself in the observatory. She's buried in the data. But it's already out here in the world. I need to see how it adapts.
How what adapts? Stephen, try to explain.
Lizzie, listen. Be ready. I need to go. It's moving again. I'll call you later.
Do you think she'll like it?
You know the protocol.
That doesn't matter now. It's figured out how to circumvent the telecommunications blackout.
What?
I didn't think it could. Kate Kate understood. She saw how adaptable it was, how smart.
Jesus Christ, you're talking about it like it's alive.
You have to assume that every...
Darling Stephen, I don't know if...
Have they closed the tunnel?
There's no trains. I've put up a sign.
The tunnel, Howard, is it closed?
I think so. I don't like it. It's not right at all.
Stop whining. It doesn't help anyone. Did you know you're bleeding?
Oh, it's this headache. It's just killing me. I haven't had a nosebleed like this since I was a kid.
But you've not been to the village?
No, I've been here the last couple of days or at home. We've only spoken to Clive at the EMC on the phone. Well, tried to anyway, but with all the crossed lines...
But no direct contact with any other people?
No, no one. What are you talking about? What's going on?
It's the pattern. It's adapted again. It doesn't need direct contact to transfer. It's using the phones.
What do you mean, direct contact? Stephen!
Is there anyone there? Can anyone hear me? Clive. Clive, it's Stephen Appleton. Are you there? Can you hear me? Over. Come on, Clive. Where are you? Damn it. Kate, it's Stephen. Come in, Tower 6. Kate, are you there? Kate? Anyone? Hello? Can anyone hear me? This is Dr. Stephen Appleton broadcasting from within the quarantine zone. Can anybody hear me? Over.
You're a daft old bird walking all the way out here for it. You know Charlie would have dropped it off.
What, and have that stinking great lorry of his poisoning my birds? He shouldn't be driving it on these lanes. It's a hazard.
I think he was hoping he could have a word with you about Frank.
There's nothing to say.
Oh, listen, Wendy, they might all be scared of you, but that's not going to work with me. You're 68 years old. Grow up. Talk to Frank.
How dare you speak to me like that? Give me my bird feeder right now.
Promise me you'll drop by and see your brother.
Megan Holloway, give...
Not a chance. Promise me. It's for your own good, and you know it.
You are a shamelessly manipulative and difficult woman. It's no wonder Charlie adores you so much.
No wonder I do what?
No wonder you never finish what you start. I thought I told you to check the incoming stock orders. Wendy, one bird feeder for you. I'll tell Frank you'll stop by.
Oh!
Charlie, stop mooning around and stick the kettle on. Make yourself useful.
Appleton! What are you doing here?
You thieving bastard. I knew it was you.
Listen.
Repeating over and over to myself in the dark, eating cold food from a can with my fingers. My name is Catherine Collins. I am Catherine Collins. As if I can force the world to acknowledge my existence. Time has ceased to exist in any real terms. I'm reduced to marking off the days on the walls, like a cavewoman. pressure in my eyes again. I can't move my legs, can't feel my face. When I collapsed, the light was waiting for me there. Caught me, lowered me here. Now it's pooling around my feet, watching me. The printers are spewing out page after page of zeros. It's frightened, too. It'll be okay. It'll be fine. I'll look after you. It's alone. It's scared. Oh, it's traveled so far. It's okay. I can help you. We can be together now. 10 seconds to signal fusion. We can be together. 3 seconds.
What do you want me to say? You knew what you were getting into.
Really?
Well, I'm sorry we don't measure up to your exacting standards, Dr. Collins. Maybe you just need to give us ordinary humans a break.
What? Ordinary humans like Lizzie Graves? Did you really think that I wouldn't find out? Frank told me, or did you forget there's one person in this shithole who actually talks to me?
Kate, it was just a drink.
Don't bother, Stephen!
Kate, slow down.
You were engaged to her, Stephen. You nearly married her.
Oh, come on, it was just a drink.
Then why the hell did you lie to me about it?
Because I knew you'd be mad and then it would end up in a row. You wanted to focus on the event tonight.
Oh, so you were actually doing me a favor. Wow, I guess I just forgot to say thank you. Do not treat me like I'm an idiot.
You're overreacting. I know you're stressed.
Just don't.
Kate, come on, this is crazy.
Jesus, man, what have you done to your face?
It's nothing. You collecting feed? Looks like the supplies have been coming in.
Again?
Phones are strange. I can't pinpoint the logic of transmission.
You what? What are you doing with that paint?
Means the EMC are actually moving at the proper speed. Listen, Frank. Have you heard anything on the radio about a flu outbreak?
Doesn't seem much like flu to me.
They're shutting down access to the valley to try and isolate it. No. Something about the phones. I can't put my finger on it quite yet.
What are you talking about? Hey, I'm still talking to you. Where are you going?
There's no one left. Just me. You know what this is? What I'm gonna do? You want light? Fine. I'll give you light. But after me, there's no one. You'll be all alone again. Forever. Like before.
I don't know if anyone will ever hear this. It's all over. I'm the only one left.
Reaches out from the shadow of the tower, across the observatory, over the valley, and consumes the world. Everything is light now. Everything has come to rest. The world is scored by the traces we carved into it. Our presence is everywhere, the bridge joining our stories. This world existed before we came to it, and it will continue without us. In the empty fields and houses, our traces radiate, and others will come to dance in the light we cast. We can slip away gently, unafraid, knowing that everything will continue.